But make sure that one of the servants always stays in front of the door. Nothing may harm her.
Of course. Anything that I can still bring your graces?
It is all right. We'll serve ourselves. You may go.
How sweet you are when you're worried and think you can keep secrets from me.
Am I? Well, I think this evening was a damn waste of time. Don't know why we had to go to the theater in London. We should have stayed in and cared for my daughter. It might look suspicious this way.
Nonsense! You must go out more. You soon be minister again. The public must see you. We must meet people.
Brandy?
No, thank you.
At least the play was amusing. Sidney Grundy's new woman certainly is a laugh. But I think he pokes too much fun at them. They are not as bookish as he shows them. Women are on the rise.
My stupid old darling. Women have never been on the rise.
Eh?
You ought to know. In your whole life, you had only two weaknesses. Your political ambition and women. You have always adored beautiful women. And you had your share of them, didn't you?
In this world, there are two tragedies. One is not getting what one wants, and the other is getting it. The last is much the worst. The last is a tragedy, as we can see. I wanted you so badly, because you were young, beautiful, and apparently helpless. And now, see what I got.
A young, beautiful lady. You know exactly what you got. And don't tell me you don't enjoy your marriage. I do, and I know you do. I know everything you like, and everything that worries you. I know that you occasionally sit in your library, look at the old photographies of that young woman called Beth, and then you cry. My poor darling.
My first real love. I wanted to marry her.
But she wouldn't. You had a child.
How do you know?
There is very little Daddy or I don't know. You took the child in. It's Wilder.
Can you be so cruel?
It's part of my character. And it's one of the reasons why women are not on the rise. We have always been on top. And I control you just as much as Cleopatra controlled and directed her Anthony. We don't need to hold any office. We hold the real power. And I know that you will do anything I want.
Why?
Because you don't want to get your little darling's heart. And because you want sex with me.
Yes.
And will you do what I want?
Yes.
Then come to bed and get your reward. Help me with my corset.
Sure, they said 2 o'clock.
Yes. Have you got your revolver?
Certainly. There's the little bench over there. We should spread out and wait for them. It's shortly before 2. I'm sure it's all perfectly harmless, as far as any of this unnatural practices can be. The two ladies are quite attractive, I've been told, and having a secret rendezvous. In London, this would be less of a problem. I mean, if they are really not interested in the male sex, that's what comes from teaching at a school where there are only women.
They spoke about finishing a plan now that Holmes is gone and you are going. To me, this sounds suspicious.
If you insist, and still, you in these man's clothes.
I can move better in them. Freer, have one mouth clothed regularly. On the stage and off the stage.
You're a strange woman. Will you wait over there, Lestrade?
Turn down your light.
All right.
My revolver points directly at your neck, so kindly don't give me any reason to shoot you. How often have you hoped for this moment? Dr. Watson in my hands, the one half of a famous detective duo that has crossed my path so often. The professor will be most glad to hear of this. Now, which way will it be, Doctor? Conscious or unconscious? Will you come with me, or will we have to carry you? Feet first.
I'm not stupid. So you say Professor Moriarty's behind all this here?
I'm sure Holmes already knows. He hasn't told you yet, has he? He always keeps information to himself so that he appears clever in the end. But it is only keeping information back that does the trick. If you had all the news he has, you would come to the same brilliant conclusions. Now, will you join me in my manor for a glass of brandy?
How could I refuse if I'm so kindly invited?
I could have sworn there were a few of you. Watson, you're a gentleman. Tell me, how many were you?
There was a little boy who led us through the side entrance. He left us there.
Ah, move along then.
This, and I am not quite sure if Mr. Holmes will like it that you wait for him here while he's out.
Oh, ma'am, that'll be quite all right. We are old buddies. Any idea when he'll be back?
No, sir. He left 2 hours ago, and from what I know of him, it can be long before he's back.
Any chance of any tea?
I see what can be done. You're the second visitor since his return. The other one promised to return later. I can hardly wait for it.
You forget, perhaps, that I saw you in this disguise before. It was what you were wearing when you were best man to Godfrey at St. Monica's. At that time, I didn't recognize you, but now I do.
And I must compliment you on your memory, on your analytical intelligence, and on your looks in male attire. You fooled me at the time, and even now I had to look really well. You're still an actress.
Hope it won't be a shock to Mrs. Hudson when she finds out that I'm a woman.
She's used to quite a lot. Tell me, what leads you here?
It's a disaster. Dr. Watson and Inspector Lestrade have been caught and kidnapped by Colonel Moran.
No surprise. probably laid out a most convincing trap as soon as I was gone. I did not expect it to happen quite as fast, but I expected it. Soon I will have my second visitor who will then threaten and tell me what might happen to them if I do not stop my investigations.
But you told everyone you had stopped them.
Which those enemies will never believe. In contrast to Scotland Yard and Inspector Lestrade, those enemies are clever, well-organized, and absolutely unscrupulous. The meeting with the representative will be most elementary, because the slightest mistake on our side will mean the instant death of one or both of our friends. Will you assist me?
You mean in place of Dr. Watson?
I'd like to have an assistant, a sidekick. Dr. Watson is invaluable. He doesn't see everything and he overlooks the most important things, but sometimes he has a way of seeing simply all important basic facts that he puts his finger in the sorest point. You are analytical, practical, and intelligent. Both unusual in a woman. You can be helpful, too.
I would be honored, Mr. Holmes. Anything else I can do when your visitor arrives?
Can you manage a gun?
The King of Bohemia always said I was a dead shot.
I expected as much. So, you best put on your cap again and stay in the background, ready to shoot in case our visitor makes any real trouble.
I thought you might want one too, Mr. Holmes. Your other visitor is downstairs.
Young or old?
Elderly gentleman. Can I send him up?
Pray do.
Do you know him?
Personally, yes. If we are lucky, we'll now make the rare acquaintance of Professor Moriarty, the most brilliant criminal in the whole British Empire. And if we are lucky, we will survive that acquaintance and finish him in return.
Less frontal development than I should have expected. I hope your friend, Mrs. Norton, knows how to hold a loaded gun. You evidently don't know me.
On the contrary, I think it is fairly evident that I do. Pray take a chair. I can spare you 5 minutes if you have anything to say.
All that I have to say has already crossed your mind.
Then possibly my answer has crossed yours.
You stand fast.
Absolutely.
You've crossed my path once. Too often, Mr. Holmes. On the 4th of January, you crossed my path for the first time. On the 23rd, you incommoded me. In the middle of February, I was seriously inconvenienced by you. And at the end of March, I was absolutely hampered in my plans. And now, at the close of April, I find myself placed in such a position through your continual persecution that my business positively suffers and I am forced to take unusual methods.
Have you any suggestions to make?
You must drop it, Mr. Holmes. You know you really must. People might come to harm.
This is what hinders me. You see, I left Charlton. I dropped the case. Lestrade had solved it, and then this abduction.
Holmes, don't insult my intelligence. It is a method your problem. Had you seen me leave a place while leaving your sidekick behind? He himself described it in many of his illustrious books. Leaving without reading. Cleverly thought out for less intelligent opponents. It has been an intellectual treat to me to see the way in which you have grappled with this affair.
I was drawn in.
I must say, unaffectedly, that it would be a grief to me to be forced to take any extreme measure. Oh, you smile, sir, but I assure you that it really would.
Danger is part of my trade.
But this is not danger. It is inevitable destruction. You stand in the way not only of an individual, but of a mighty organization, the full extent of which you, with all your cleverness, have been unable to realize. You must.